Hi, this is Carol from Tiny Space Health. Today I'm just going to go through just some hamstrings, a few sort of glutes, leg stretches on the floor. So come and join me on the floor. I'm also going to use my towel to help me get a little bit more into those stretches. Or it's particularly good if you're new. I'm just going to just roll it up while I talk to you. If you're fairly new to doing stretches, towels are really good just to help sort of sometimes just get into positions where it's hard to grab your hands. So yeah, I'm going to use that today. Not for everything, but for some things. And then we're going to do a couple of really nice relaxing twists on the floor. Okay, so nice and easy. Come down onto the floor, just roll down or whatever you want to do, flop down. Okay, I'm just going to roll down very elegantly, flop. I've got my towel nearby. I'm going to start with a hamstring stretch. So one leg is bent, and then this one is going to, this is going to be my hamstring stretch. Okay, so this one's going to come up here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook that towel around it, and I'm going to use my towel to help stretch out the hamstring. So I'm flexing my foot, lying down, just relaxing the arms down. You can use a yoga strap or, I don't know, a piece of rope, I guess. Sorry, I just thought of Batman then. You know, Batman with his autopilot rope. But anyway, you just pull that in towards you. So I'm pulling my leg this way. And a little, the leg's straight, but it's not completely. I'm not trying to lock it out completely. Now, if that's even too hard for you to do there, you can always just have this here. You can always just grab it behind there and use that to do a hamstring stretch. But you have to sort of make sure you really engage the knee. You do that. Okay. Just try to get a bit more of a stretch. Okay, breathe. I sort of like to do pointing ones too, so I like to point the foot, because sometimes, you know, day to day, just walking around, we don't really go into this position unless we're a ballerina, I guess. And then flex the foot. And point again. And flex. Okay. Just going to bend that knee a little bit. Tuck it into my chest and then straighten that other leg. I'm just going to let this fall wherever it goes at the moment. Just tuck it in and then just roll it around. Roll a bit of a hip, that's a stretch. Roll it around. Not the rolling around, but this one here. Okay. So, I'm going to bend that knee again. Not for too long. Just going to go back to, you know, remember we were doing the hamstring stretch? We're going to grab this towel, my towel, with the opposite hand. The same hand as that leg is going to go onto the ground. I'm going to keep my shoulders down. I'm going to go across the body, but keeping this knee up. So don't let it fall down. Just have the knee up. And what I'm doing is just this little stretch down the outside of the thigh. Now the outside. So that's about far enough for me. I can feel that already. I'm using this just to help support it a little bit. Breathing. And I'm just going to come back to center. And then I'm going to cross it across my knee. And you might find some people, what we do is a glute stretch, so I'm just going to grab through here. But if that's a bit hard, because sometimes it is, and sometimes you're just like, oh, I don't want to do that, and that's fair too, just sort of use the towel, and the towel can just help pull it in. So I can relax my shoulders onto the ground here, flexing this foot on top. That was a good crack. So I'm doing a glute stretch here. This is stretching out into the butt in here. You can always do it with the hands through the middle as well, hands through the window. You don't need use a towel. Just thought I'd show a couple of different options for a change. Okay. So I'm going to keep this around here. I'm going to bend that leg. So the one that I've used is now going down. This one's going straight up into a hamstring stretch. So I'm just going to flex my foot. I'm going to be here for a bit. Or if I want to, I can just hook it around there. Whatever you like. But I'm already here, so I'm just going to stay here. Try to bring it in a little bit. Slight bend in the knee, relaxing the shoulders down. Pointing the toe, just for a change. And then flexing the foot. And then doing that again, pointing the toe. This one, we tucked it into the chest. As I'm tucking this one in, I want to make sure this leg goes straight. Now, if that's comfy for you there, you can stay there, but it actually increases more of the stretch into here if you have that leg straight, okay? So just do what's right for you. I'm going to roll the ankle. So like a hamstring stretch again, okay? Same hand as that leg goes out to the side, palm down to the floor. I'm sort of going for the wall here, but it doesn't matter. Okay, opposite hand goes to the towel, or if you haven't got a towel, to the outside of the thigh, okay? And we're going to bring that across, really focusing on this leg here, knee staying up. Stretch on that outside of the thigh here on the other side. Keeping the shoulders down. Pretty straight leg here. Flex foot as well. Really good one for our thigh. Just trying to make sure my knees up. That's good. And then coming back. And then I'm actually going to let that go way down the back of my thigh. Cross it across. Actually, I'm on the wrong leg, aren't I? Whoops, sorry. There we go. I'm getting tangled in my towel. Okay, I'm crossing it across because I'm going to do a glute stretch. So we're on the we're on the right side, trust me. But you can go through the middle here, but I'm just showing you if you're using a towel, you can just tuck it under there and just use it to help pull it in. Flexing the foot on top if you can. And then you're going to feel it through the glute, which is your butt on the other side. Just relax down. If you go, oh, that feels all right, then use your towel, pull it in a little bit more. Okay, just challenge yourself a little bit, but still just be careful. You'll just feel it, it shouldn't be painful. But you should feel the stretch. I'm just going to untangle myself here. I'm going to put my towel down. We're going to do a little twist. Okay, so I'm getting my hands out to the side here. And I've still got a bit of a wall there, just ignore that. My hands are up. I'm just going to sort of bring it out here for now. Okay, I'm going to lift my knees up. I'm going to imprint my spine into the floor. As soon as I lift my knees up, imprint the spine into the floor. I'm going to let them bring them across one way. Just do a little twist. Now, if you feel, oh, that's a bit too hard, then you can always just have your feet here, just down on the floor, and just let them fall like that. And you can just go, that's enough, okay? But if you want to make it a little bit harder, you lift them up, and you bring them down to the side. You just put the feet down. The knees don't have to touch the floor. We're just doing a little twist in there, in the lower spine. I'm being a bit careful. I injured my lower back. Just not too bad. Just gave a little bit of strain a couple of weeks ago. So this is actually the first time I've done a twist for a while, so I'm taking it a bit easy because I don't want to injure that again. But I'm just happy I can do this. I'm just looking up. By the way, you can always look the way the knees are. You can look up, you can look away. If I was looking away, I'm getting more of a twist through the upper spine. But I'm not worried about that just at the moment. Just gonna go where I am. And breathe into it. Okay, I'm gonna come up through center. I'm still imprinting my spine here, which means I'm really pushing my lower spine into the mat here. Because every time you lift, I'm just going to put my feet down. When I'm in this position, I've got a little arch in my spine, but then as soon as I try to lift my knees up, I should always push the spine down, so should you as well, just to support your lower back. Okay, so arms out to the side, and then I'm going to let those knees drop to the other side. Now I'm going to be a little bit careful this time because I'm going to walk into the wall anyway. But I'm going to keep my feet down and do the other one. Okay, so I'm keeping my feet down here about shoulder width. I'm just going to let them fall. And see, I'm feeling that through here, but I'm getting a little bit of a stretch through my lower spine as well. Not quite as much as if I had my knees up. But that's okay. See, that's the right thing for me to do today. So hopefully you found either of those ones is right for you. And eye gaze wherever you like. And then we're just going to bring those knees up. And I'm going to just stretch out again, just a long stretch through the body, just sort of. It's not really a counter stretch to the twist, but it just feels nice. I'm going to stretch out, reach out here, and then just relax, okay? So you're going to do that one more time. Big stretch out. Big stretch. 2 inches taller, I wish. And then just relax. Okay. So here's our second twist. Okay, so we're still just doing it here on the ground. I'm not going to sit up. There's lots of ones I can show you sitting up, but we're just going to lie down because it's sort of nice just lying on the floor. So we're just going to bring one leg up. We're going to bring this other one across and cross it as if you're just sort of sitting on a seat and crossing your legs. Hands can be at the side. They can be down here, wherever you like. I'm sort of still feeling it out the side here. And I'm just going to let that fall a little bit across. That feels actually quite comfortable for me. I guess I'm going to sit with my legs crossed fairly often when I'm in a seat. That feels comfy for me. But if that doesn't feel comfy for you, go back to the first one that we did because it's quite nice to do another stretch. Even working the same area because we don't really stretch our spine very much. So remember, once again, eye gaze that way. Eye gaze can be up, okay? Or if you're feeling like, oh, I want to do a little bit more twist through the upper spine, you just look away. I'm resting my foot here on the ground, sort of taking a bit, that foot here is taking a bit of the weight of my leg. Just a little bit. Your shoulders, close your eyes if you like. I'll try not to fall asleep. We'll come back to the center and we can work the other side. So just cross the upper leg across and then just let that one. I'm going to whack onto that plant on top. It's going to, it doesn't matter. Be good, plant. You'll be fine. I'm just going to let that drop. To the first. first one if you feel that's a bit hard. Okay? Just feet on the, both the feet on the mat, and then just let them drop across. Just try to relax the shoulders. It's not hurting my back, but I'm feeling it a little. I'm feeling the little stretch where I actually injured my back. Just a little bit of a stretch in there, so I'm being really careful. So you should be careful as well. Always just, you know, be kind to yourself. And then we're going to lift that one back up. Back down. And this big stretch out. Nearly finished. Big stretch. One more. You have to do one more of those. Okay, point the toes, stretch the fingers, stretch out the tummy. And you're nearly there. And just relax. And I'm just going to lie here, stay here on the floor for a little while and have a little rest. And yeah, thanks for joining me. I should come up, shouldn't I? I'll just come up halfway. So I'm lounging here. So thanks for joining me, and I'll catch you next time. See you. Bye.